Hi, my name is Dr. Kimberly Manning, and I'm a general internist in Atlanta, Georgia. And you know, I've been thinking a lot over the last several months, as I'm sure you have, about vaccinations and about the reasons why people do or don't agree to be vaccinated. You know, I'm not the authority on convincing people or understanding why people make the decisions they do about being vaccinated or not being vaccinated. But what I am the authority on is me. And what I can tell you is that I know what it's like for me to have someone cut me off when I'm talking, to have someone ask me a question, but not really be interested in the answer, to have someone assume based upon what I look like or what they think about me, how I'll feel about something, what I'll say, the reason why I might do a certain thing without asking me. And so with those things in mind, that's really how I approach having conversations about those who are still in the process of deliberating about being vaccinated. And notice that I use the word deliberate. You know, I'm admittedly not a huge fan of this term hesitancy, because it really suggests that maybe you're afraid or something else, when maybe the decision for you is such a big decision that you are still deliberating. And so, when I get into these conversations, I kind of start at one point. I ask myself, am I in a clinical environment or am I in a non-clinical environment? If I'm in a clinical environment, it's first important to remember, hey, wait a minute, what might be this patient's agenda? What things are they most concerned about that I should be addressing before I leap into a conversation about vaccinations? Maybe this individual is someone who's worried about their blood pressure. Maybe they had an abnormal mammogram. Maybe there's just some blood work that you haven't quite mentioned what the values are or the results are of them, and they're really nervous about that. And so, given that, I try to make sure to tackle those things that could be sort of in the cognitive space of the individual before launching into a discussion about vaccinations. And then after that, I'll ask, hey, have you been vaccinated or what do you think about the vaccine? Specifically, in this current context, mostly we're talking about the COVID vaccine. Now, sometimes the person says, yeah, I've been vaccinated. Sometimes the person says, I haven't yet. I'm thinking about it. And sometimes the person is like, no way. And generally, my next question, again, is a respectful one because I want to talk about something that you are ready to talk about. I'll ask, hey, do you mind me asking you why you feel the way you do? And then I prepare to listen to why. Maybe it's because they're scared that it could cause them to have a clot. Maybe they're afraid that it could lead to infertility. Maybe they believe that it was developed too quickly. I don't know. Or maybe they just haven't gotten around to getting it yet. Maybe they're scared and want somebody to just hold their hand when they get the vaccine. It varies from person to person, and you will not know unless you ask why. And once the person says why, I'm prepared to hear what they have to say and then address each step. So for example, if someone says, hey, I heard that you could get clots or you could get, you know, inflammation of your heart. So, you know, it's important to acknowledge what is true. It is true that some people developed clots, though rare. It is true that some people developed myocarditis, though rare. So respecting our patients enough to have those conversations and to share the evidence and the base rate and the likelihood of something like that happening to them, I think people appreciate that. Furthermore, when I'm in the community, I do the same thing. Hey, what'd you think about that COVID vaccine? And if someone says they're against it or they haven't had it or they're thinking about it, it's the same thing. Hey, would you mind telling me why you feel the way you do? Would you be willing to talk about it? And if they are open to talking about it, I listen to what their concerns are and then probe further. So if I understand correctly, blank. And I think if there's anything else that's most important, it is this: recognizing that when we have those conversations, we are planting seeds. We are not used car salesmen. Sometimes people won't say yes on the spot. For many people, these conversations are conversations that they need some time to think about. It's like when someone shows you a house, right? Or a new car. You may need to go home and think about it. Think about what it means to you. And maybe to you, if you do not come from a historically disadvantaged group, that if you have never been over-policed, if you haven't had your life threatened day to day, every day, maybe this was an easy decision for you and you didn't have to deliberate for a long time. But that's you, and you're an expert in you. The only way to find out what our patients want, need, and care about is to ask the expert on them, and that is them. So keep the dialogue open, plant the seed, and know that sometimes plants grow even after we've walked away from them. Good luck.